Hi everyone, it's Andrea here, and of course today is day one of Grace's Colour Along. So this is a colour along that's being hosted by Grace Fonseca. I'll leave a link to her channel below, I think, you know, if you want to have a look, see what's going on. Basically, she's got a colour along going where you can colour anything by Daria Song. So I've got the Time Garden, I bought that in London, as you know. I don't know which picture I'm going to do in it yet, I haven't decided. But that's there in case I finish doing the picture in the Jade Summer Vampire, because you can also use Jade Summer. And I want to colour one of the vampire pictures. You can also use anything by Hannah Carlson, anything from Magical Delight, or anything from the Buffy the Vampire Slayer colouring book. So I only have the Daria Song and the Jade Summer ones. I've quite a lot of Jade Summer, to be honest. I really like the Jade Summer books. So before we get colouring, I just want to show you what I've been doing. Since I got back from London, I didn't want to start anything big because I knew that we would be doing this. Before I went to London, I started colouring in one of the pages on the Terry Pratchett's Discworld, and that was just this front page here, this front screen. I haven't finished it yet, but it's nearly done. And that was just to have a fiddle with the colours and see what they look like on the paper. So that's that one. And I've also started colouring in my Colour Your Own graphic novel, Bram Stoker's Dracula. Adapted and illustrated by John Green. And I started colouring in the front page Dracula, just so you can see, just to have a little practice. I haven't finished him yet, but it was just so that I had an idea of how to colour it. But I have done the very first page of the book, which is this page, which is just Jonathan Harker arriving to in Carpathia to go and visit with Count Dracula about buying property in England. So I've only done that first page and I really enjoyed it, and it was really, really fun to do. So I'm looking forward to doing that. So as you can see, I haven't done any more. So that was what I've done there. So next, I am going to do, not that one, I've marked a few of the ones I want to do, so I've just got to find the one I want. I'll put that one over. That one. This one. This is the one I'm going to do. I really like this one, and I'm going to change it because I don't think he looks much like a vampire. I'm just wondering what I've done with my sharpener. Oops, I think it's over here. Yeah. So I'm going to do this one, but I'm actually going to change it a little bit. I'm going to make him a little bit more scary. So I'm going to do this one from this book. So I'm not going to do much tonight because I am expecting a nice delivery from the Amazon Fairy tomorrow. So I am just going to start a little bit of it, and then of course when the Amazon fairies come and I'm doing tomorrow's video, I'll show you exactly what it is I've got. So at the moment I'm using my Derwent Colour Softs. I will probably change that. I've also got my Faber-Castell Classics here because there are certain things I do want to change on it. I just think he looks too clean cut to be a vampire, and I just want to take it back and make it more horrific. So they both look like vampires to me, though she's not wearing very much obviously. So it looks like she's got blood running down her mouth as well as he has. The idea is I am going to make him look different. I don't want him to be your typical vampire, but you'll see how Well, I do want him to be the typical vampire. I don't want him to be the typical clean-cut vampire. So I'm going to actually use the pencils to change the art style slightly. I'm not an artist. In fact, I'm hopeless at art, but I do like colouring. When I say I'm hopeless at art, I say I can't draw to save my life. I do like... I like colouring them in, but I am hopeless at actually drawing. But I'm just going to do it how I want it to look. So, I'm extremely tired today, so it's going to be a little bit different. And basically when I say I'm going to change things, I'm going to change the hairline slightly, and I'll probably change the shape of his jaw. He looks too clean cut to be a vampire, in my opinion, but that's just me. I guess I've got an old fashioned idea of what vampires should be like. Yee-hoo. That's the one I want as well, my Prussian grey. Looking at... I will be turning the book because I am left-handed, so sometimes I find it very easier if I turn the book on its side. Let's focus that in there, because I'm going to have a look at this thing here, which is a bat, one of the bats. So yeah, London was great. London's always great, I'm not gonna lie. I love London. And what I loved, I just love going to London and seeing my friend who lives in Oval. Oops. And we went to see Frankie Valli on Sunday, and this happened because last year we went to see the Jersey Boys in London, which we really, really enjoyed. And Frankie Valli then came to announce his tour. We didn't know he was announcing his tour at this point. He was on a TV programme in the UK called The One Show, which is on BBC One at like 7 o'clock at night, really. And he said, Paul said, I love Frankie Valli, I love the music. And I do, to be honest, I love all that. Slightly out of focus here, I'm just going to pull it out a little bit. That's it, like that. All that old 60s music. We both love it. So I said to Paul, we were watching the Frankie Valli on The One Show, and I said, oh, all right, if he comes on tour, because he was going on about how he'd like to see him live, if he comes on tour, we'll go and see him. And of course, that same day on that same programme, he announced the tour, and Paul was like, hey, and I was like, oh, all right then. So we got tickets. I was a little bit mad to say it, because I should have known better than to say it, because it happened. And so we went to see Frankie Valli, and oh my god, it was a brilliant concert. And considering that Frankie Valli is 82 years old, I was quite amazed that he can still hit all those really high notes, you know, because as you get older, your voice changes and you lose a lot of the high register. So for Frankie Valli to still be able to hit those really high notes, I was absolutely amazed. I thought it was fantastic that he could still do it. And I have to admit, he sang, they did Silence is Golden. And oh my God, it was beautiful. It's one of the most beautiful versions I've ever heard. The harmonies were stunning. And I just felt that it made me cry. I'm not gonna lie. It really, really made me cry because it was so beautiful. So beautifully done. As you can see with the hair, I'm not doing this very carefully because I want him to look slightly more dangerous. I don't think he looks very dangerous. He's too clean cut. So we're just gonna that's what I like about these books, is you can do it. So yeah, I mean, I have this list of songs that I really like live, and it doesn't often, it's very hard for me to add things to it, but Silence is Golden is definitely up there on my favourites to be sung live. Along with don't worry, I know what I'm doing. What else was it? God, what was it? Oh, Live and Let Die by Paul McCartney is another one. That was amazing. I've seen that live. We saw Paul McCartney live a few years ago at the O2 as well. And then I've also seen The Who and Baba O'Reilly. That's also brilliant. Really, really live. It was one of the most amazing things I've ever, ever witnessed in my entire life was Baba O'Reilly live. Absolutely brilliant. And so yeah, Baba O'Reilly and Live and Let Die, and of course Silence is Golden. Absolutely beautiful. Beautiful live. So I'm just wondering what colour to do her hair. I'm thinking we could do her like a blondie colour. With my light, my ochre, my yellow ochre, and my yellow ochre, it's three for now, and which is the darkest, the brightest is that one, so that's light sand, I'll go with this one. Okay, so I think that, yeah, Frankie Valli was absolutely brilliant. Now, we also went to see the Motown, the musical. The Shaftesbury Theatre, which was also very, very good. Obviously it tells the story of the Motown record label and Diana Ross and all that. And it's very good. Performances were absolutely brilliant. I really, really enjoyed them. And yeah, they were good. The singers were very, very good. And it, you know, it's all those songs that everybody knows. Like My Guy and My Girl and just absolutely brilliantly executed, I thought. Enjoyed that very, very much. So I would recommend that if you are going to the London anytime and you're going to the West End and you're not sure what to see, but you know you want to, I would say go and see Motown the Musical. It's really good. I really, really enjoyed it. So again, as you can see, I'm not being overly careful with the hair because I'm going over it with different shades of yellow and blonde. So, I mean, these guys are practically naked. So it's going to be interesting to decide how to do their skin. So there's going to be all sorts of colours in her hair. So that's why I've just given it a quick I like it with the Jade Summer books. You have got, you've seen what I've done, but that's what it looks like at the moment. So much, because Jade Summer puts in two copies of her book, of her pictures in each book, which is fantastic, because that means that you can, obviously, if you don't like what you're doing, you can do it again. And one of the things I'll be doing is at the end is I will probably scan the original picture, because this is the other copy, and I will take it out to show you. We'll put both of them together at the end. It's kind of like a comic book look on this one, but I still want to make him a little bit more scary. I don't think he's very scary at all. I don't know why they give these vampires knives. They've got teeth. Yeah, what are they going to do with a knife? Vampires, they're just going to want to bite you. I think the problem with vampires these days is there's just too much of the twinkling going on. To me, vampires do not twinkle. Vampires are not supposed to be nice. They're supposed to be actually quite evil. And I'm not sure, you know, that this whole business, I mean, I got nothing against Twilight by Stephanie Meyer, not at all. I think she's a great writer. I actually like the latest book she released, The Chemist. I think it's absolutely brilliant. I've read it. I gave it 5 stars. I read it at the beginning of the year. But the whole vampire thing, which is like, why are they twinkling? You know, they go out during the daytime and they're nice-ish. I like the idea of vampires being evil, because, I mean, there's enough evil in the world, don't get me wrong, but to me they always have been evil, and to make them nice and twinkly, to me it just spoils it. But, I mean, you know, I guess, yeah. There are nice vampires, obviously if you've watched Buffy the Vampire Slayer, but even there, the vampires that are good and have their souls restored can still become bad again. They can lose their souls. So, I quite like her hair. It's very comic book. I'm not really going for any particular highlights. I'm literally just colouring it in different colours just to give it, gives it a bit of texture, really. So, I am enjoying this one. I like this picture. So, yeah, so, I mean, basically, to me, vampires aren't nice. Is that what I want? No, that's peach. They're only nice in things like, you know, obviously Angel had his moments in Buffy, and you know, and Spike had his moments for various reasons in Buffy. But yeah, to me, vampires aren't supposed to be nice. They're supposed to be evil. And they're supposed to not be able to go out during the daytime. So I've got a Prismacolor clear blending pencil, but because I'm left-handed, I obviously sharpen it the wrong way around. Because I'm left-handed, so everything I do is scrammy. Cack-handed, as they say. Can't help it, I just am. So I've put a bit of brown in her hair as well, just to give it a bit of texture. Especially at the roots, because the truth is that all blondes, real blondes, well, natural blondes tend to have dark roots, and it's not that they're, it's just the way it is. My mum was a natural blonde for years till she got older. I was a natural blonde for years, and now I've got red hair because I dye it. And she had dark roots, and people always say that it's common to have dark roots, even though it's natural, because a natural blonde will do. So she used to get something that they used to spray in, sort of like a sun in type thing, and she used to spray it in. Lemon juice works just as well. But for me, obviously, I was blonde when I was little. Now, not so much. Now, not at all, actually. My hair is just a dark brown with red low lights, natural low lights in it, so I now have it dyed a red colour. I like red. It looks nice on me. It's quite bright. I'm just gonna, here and there, just put in a bit of that. Just to does look quite nice now. I like her hair. So I'm staying away from certain areas because I'm hoping that tomorrow when the Amazon fairy comes, there's obviously colouring supplies in that Amazon fairy hall, that I'll be able to show you some more using some different pencils tomorrow once I've colour swatched them. I have ordered a colour swatch book as well, but I don't think that's coming until Sunday. So yeah, but I have ordered some more pencils. I was going to get either the Derwent Inktenses or the Caran d'Ache Neo Colour 2s, but I spent enough on Amazon today. Today was payday. That's why. And I had done a lot of overtime. And because I'd done a lot of overtime, more money go into my bank account today than I would normally have, so I sort of treat myself. So I've ordered some nice stuff. There are some more colouring books as well, I'm not gonna lie, but So yeah, I've ordered some more colouring books, which I will show you. There's another Jade Summer one in there. I was talking about London. I got distracted by talking about vampires, didn't I? Okay. Never mind. Day two of London, Monday. I got to be honest, I spent most of the day sleeping because we changed hotels. Because we always change hotels. We go in... when we're at the O2, we go and stay at a particular hotel in Canary Wharf called, well, it's a Point Hotel, and we stay there. It's all right. I wouldn't want to stay there for too long, but it's all right for one night, maybe two at the most. And we then always move into central London because, yeah, that's what I want. We had the half snores and badly. And I normally take with me some earplugs and I forgot them. So I didn't really sleep after the Frankie Valli concert. So we went to the Royal Scots Travelodge in King's Cross, where we moved to, bought some earplugs, and I went to sleep for most of the afternoon on the Monday, I'm not gonna lie. But that was okay, because I was so tired, I went out like a light. Normally don't go out that much during the day, but I had to. There you go. So just so that I'm just showing you, I'm just giving her hair a bit more definition by putting some black lines through it, so it just makes it look a bit more. Like that. So just do that. Do we just smudge it in a bit to make it look a bit more natural? You can see a bit darkness in the hairline as well. There we go. Yeah, and then we went to see, like I said, we went to see Motown the Musical, and as I showed you, I stopped in to Forbidden Planet and got myself the Wonder Woman Funko Pop because I love it. And that was it really on that day. Like I said, Motown was really good. And then on the Tuesday, we went up to the Cutty Sark to have a look. I went on the Cutty Sark when I was really, really little. I mean, I'm talking about 7 or 8 with the school. And they recently restored it. They had a fire in a few years ago, which destroyed not a lot of it, but a little bit of it during the restoration process, which was really... This is the first time I've had problems with my Colorsoft pencils breaking, and I think it's me. I don't think it's them. And empty this again soon. So maybe that's my mum. I hadn't been since, and it was fantastic to go on there again. Because, like I said, I haven't been since I was like about 8. And all I can remember from when I went on their previously, when I was little, was that it was... Okay, I don't know what happened there, but the recording stopped for some reason. So I do apologise, I don't know what I've missed.
It was really nice.
But yeah, so we went to Cathay Sark. Hadn't been there for a long time since I was little. I can remember when we went, when I was very little, I can remember buying a necklace, which was in the shape of the ship's wheel. But I don't really remember much else. So yeah, it was really nice to go again. And then we walked up to the Royal Observatory, which is only up the road really, it's not very far up the hill. And I think that goes there. That one goes there. Peach. Yeah, so we walked up the hill to the Royal Observatory, which was really nice. Had a wander around looking at all the implements and instruments. So, for instance, all the various clocks and things, which was really nice. But, yeah, it was really, really good. We had some... some lunch at Nando's. We went for what they call it, what we in the UK call it, cheeky Nando's, and that was nice. And then we went and sat in the pub. We went into a pub called the Gypsy Moth, which is right by the Cathay Sark. Had a couple of drinks before we waited for my friend Philip. He came. And we then went down to Island Gardens to a curry house called the Gaylord, which my brother Richard went to for a while when he was living in London. And he said, go there and tell them that the chap in the hat that ordered a fowl every night sent you. Now, a fowl is obviously, if you don't know, a very hot curry. And my brother, he lives in New Zealand and they don't make curries very hot out there. So he always asks for, over here, the curry to be fowl hot, because if he's lucky, he might get it at Vindaloo. And they thought he was rather funny. They remembered him. And they thought, yeah, that was amusing. When I mentioned it, they were like, oh yeah, we can't believe that. He had a different curry every night, but he had it foul hot. So whatever he tried, it was foul hot. And they thought that was funny. So we had a real laugh. Because I haven't seen my friend Phil for a while, because he's recently moved to London. He is an actor and singer, but he's also a social worker. He's fantastic. Hi Phil, if you see this. So yeah, it was really nice to see him, and hopefully I'll be going to see him again soon, and we're going to go and have a look around Highgate Cemetery, because my Paul, he's not keen on cemeteries. He thinks they're morbid and depressing. I love them myself, but then I've always been a bit odd. So we're going to go to Highgate Cemetery. Yeah. So we'll just go to Highgate Cemetery and have a. I've got one bright orange. Where's my blush gone? Blush pink. So yeah, we had. I had. What did I have? I had a chicken chat. I really like chicken dishes. I'm not big on other dishes. And I had a chicken kwarai, which was really nice. But we also had papadoms and naan bread, such and such stuff that you have to have. I could have done her underwear black, but you know what? I don't want it to be black. She's going to have black stockings on anyway, so. I know why, I just thought pink would be nice. Very bright pinks. Sort of give her that sort of naughty, innocent look at the same time. You know what I mean? That just bitten look. So that was London, really. And then on Wednesday, we came back. We got back about 5:30. It's really odd because you know when you're coming back into Wales, because suddenly there's clouds. Wales had been lovely while we were away. In fact, the whole of the UK had had some really lovely weather. And it had only just started raining in London when we left. But as we got to the bridge, the Severn Bridge, the second Severn Crossing, as it's called, suddenly this great big black cloud. It's like, yeah, we're back in Wales. But nice to be home, though, I've got to be honest. Apart from the fact that we're still waiting for our decorator, builder and decorator to finish with the building. It is getting there, and the walls are now a lovely blue, light blue colour. I would call it Wedgwood blue. So if you go and look up Wedgwood porcelain, it's that lovely light blue colour with the white glazing and the white decoration. That's what colour it is. It's really nice. So with all the white coving and skirting, it looks like Wedgwood's been let loose in our living room. And I really, really quite like it. Some of these pencils are going down quite quickly. I'm using the Derwent Colour Softs today. And like I said, I will be using something different tomorrow. See that, because it's off the page, there you go. So this is quite enjoying this one. But like I said, I'm quite into vampires at the moment because I'm writing a vampire story myself. I sort of like Bram Stoker, I'm taking it, I'm using the real Vlad the Impaler, or Vlad Dracula, Vlad Dracul, as my lead character, but it's actually set before that. I've got a bit of research to do, but it's not too bad. So I'm just going to shade this bit in like this. But we don't want it to be completely black, because it wouldn't. And then it'll be a little bit darker than that, but it won't be a lot. So. Yeah, it's just where they're actually standing in the rain. That's all of these lines. There are lines, if you can see them. Crossing their faces, and here this is just rain streaks. So my fella Ballad up here, he's been a vampire a while, and I'm just having him just turn her, I think. And that's the good thing with colouring, you can interpret these things however you want to. Because you are the artist, you know? So Jade Summer's drawn the picture for us, and now we're finishing it off for her. So, yeah, quite like this. As you can see, I'm just leaving a little gap around his fingers. Sounds a bit dodgy, doesn't it? And there's a reason for that, because where he will have his fingers, where there's any pressure on the material, whether it's from the clip there. It will be a slightly different colour, which is what I'm trying to do now. So I'm just going to put that in a grey colour. That. So when I do the flesh tones, what I will do is I will put a flesh tone on her leg first and upon this part of her leg, and then what I will do is I will go over the flesh with a black then, because that will then give it that whole looking of the stretched nylon. Yeah, I'm being ambitious on this, aren't I, a little bit. So you know what, we've been going for, I don't know how long for, probably about 40 minutes. I really don't know, because my camera does it in installments of 10 to 11 minutes, maybe 12, before it'll cut off, because it gets to a certain file size and I have to string them all together. Now, I know I've had two full length ones and I've had a short one because the camera turned off, so I reckon we're getting on for 40 minutes. So we're going to call it a day fairly soon, but not quite yet. So I am wondering whether to do this in like a gold or a steel. Where's my steel grey? There's pewter. And there's steel. So I'm going to do his necklace. And I've got, this is Persian grey, which is, you can't see because it won't focus, because it's trying to focus on the background. C6660, which is again, it's Derwent Colorsoft, and I've got the Derwent Steel Grey, which as you can see is a lighter color, and that's 690. And what I'm going to do with this is I'm going to do the inside bits with the, what's it called, Persian Grey,
Persian,
like this, because this is pewter or whatever it's called. What's it called? Prussian one. Just like that. If it was her jewellery, I think it would be more probably blingy. So she'd have like golds and silvers and jewels. So I'll probably do jewels on her bangle. And then the rest of it, I'm just going to sharpen that to a nice point. And we're going to do that. So tomorrow, on day two of the colour along, we'll do a bit more of this. I'll show you my purchases from Amazon. It won't be all of them, because some of them have happened to come from a different supplier. And that's just two Colorsoft pencils. So when I bought my Colorsoft set, I only bought the, I bought the 48 set in the box. I didn't get the full 72. So I've ordered myself two of the colours that aren't in the box, and I'm going to do that every time I place an Amazon order. I'm just going to order one or two of the colours I haven't got. So I've ordered lemon yellow and I think it's deep red. And then what I'll do is, as I just got to get in close because I can't see it, there we go. I'm also blind as a bat, by the way, without my glasses. So what I'm going to do is order a couple more every time I do myself an order. So I've ordered those two, and then what I'll do is I'll, as I use these, I will start a list of the ones I'm going to need. So for instance, my black is very short. So if I show you one, I haven't got a full length one, I don't think. I guess mid-grey is quite a long one. Mid-grey is like, if I just zoom it out like that, that's that long. And my black is like that long now. Because I've used it quite a lot. But that's okay. That's what they're for. They're not here to be looked at and pretty, but they're there to be used. So I think that's where I'm going to leave it for now. And so that's how much we've done. Just zoom that out so you can see it all. So we've done the hair. Like I said, I haven't finished with him. He's still too nice looking. I'm going to give him some stubble when I've done his skin, just so he's not so clean cut. And I might give him a few scars. I haven't decided yet. He's nicely chiseled, by the way. But that's where we are so far. So I hope that you're all having fun with Gracie's colouring along. And obviously tomorrow or in the next couple of days, I will announce my own colour along when I've finalised all the details. So that's it for me today. I'm going to go to bed because it's getting late. I will see you tomorrow with part 2. So I hope you've had a good colour and I'll see you soon. Bye now.